I actually would love to replace the horn on my car with Corey's that selection. Yeah, if somebody's like in front of me on I-24 and they haven't realized that, you know, traffic has picked up and started moving again, you just honk that horn and
I would fully laugh at anyone who had this as their horn, though. I would not take you serious.
Technology is catching up. We will have this one day.
This is the Woody and Jim Show podcast, a daily recap of everything you missed.
We knew the day was coming, but Netflix is cracking down on people sharing passwords.
Here's how they're doing it. They're charging you for anybody who's using your Netflix account at a different house.
Yes, per home, per month.
Yep.
$2.99. So is what they're trying out right now. We don't know if it's actually going to come to the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But they're doing it in a bunch of countries.
Mm-hmm.
And it could come to it. They said it's coming in some form.
In some form, yeah. We just don't know if this is going to be the form. It could end up being $25 per home. Who knows?
Right. Or they could say, oh, it's $50, as many homes as you want.
Exactly.
Yeah, who knows? But right now, like considering that it would say, let's say it's $3 for somebody who uses it outside your home.
Mm-hmm.
How does it affect everybody on this show personally? Let's start with Ricky Sanchez.
Doesn't affect me at all. I don't pay for my Netflix.
Okay, so it affects your...
So whose account is it?
So the ones that are on my personal laptop are my dad's.
Okay.
And then the ones that are on our TVs are AJ's, my boyfriend.
Oh, okay.
So I don't pay for any of it.
Okay. So, all right, your boyfriend's paying for some, dad's paying for the rest.
Yep.
Yeah.
Nice deal. Good work if you can get it.
No kidding.
Yep. Not mad about it at all.
Woody, what about you? How does this affect you? Say it goes into effect right now.
Except for Jeff, my son who lives in Smyrna, pretty much all my family uses my password.
Mm-hmm.
All my kids, and they're always buying new devices. So he says, "Oh, you know, you get that little notification email say somebody signed in."
Right? Yeah. So you've got a son in the Navy,
yeah,
who is in different parts of the country and
right,
world,
right,
different
and
times.
He logs on his phone no matter where he is around the world.
Your daughter in California.
Yeah. But we kind of made a deal where I use her HBO Max.
And she uses
oh,
your...
so it kind of evens
yeah,
out then.
Yeah.
In the
okay.
End.
Yeah. It's
all
like,
right.
You know, like I have Hulu, but you use my Hulu, Jim, and so does Zach.
Very rarely.
Yeah.
Yes. But yeah, you're right. It's kind of a co-op system.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I've paid for stuff and given you passwords
right,
for
yeah,
like,
Apple Plus. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, Zach.
He pays for nothing.
He pays for nothing.
He pays for nothing.
Yeah, I get it.
So, yeah, if somebody's new to the show, Zach's, he's on vacation this week, but he used to use my Netflix password
mm-hmm.
until I yanked it away from him because he was publicly shaming me for the things
I
was watching.
Watch, yeah.
He was
okay, but you should have expected that, Jim.
Yeah.
I should have.
That was a you thing.
Yeah. I should have. But
Zach
I just,
is always going to be a little judgy. Yeah.
It's Zach, for God's sake.
But being like the parent that I am to Zach... to this day,
mm-hmm.
Everybody around him is his parent. They having to make sure he doesn't get into trouble. I took it away from him.
Right.
And then a random listener started paying.
Right.
So now some guy who lives in Gallatin is going to be charged an extra $3 a month
uh-huh.
because Zach is using his password.
Mm.
Yeah.
So now it's time for you to sit down and evaluate. Is my friendship worth $3 a month?
Yeah.
For some people, they're going to say no.
Yeah.
The only person who's using my password for Netflix that I know of is my daughter, who lives in an apartment about mm-hmm. a mile from my house.
Right.
And her boyfriend, like, pirates everything else.
Oh, okay.
So I'd say, all right, well, tell him to just pirate that and let me save the $3.
You would really kick her off, Jim, for $3 a month?
You're talking to frugal Jim.
Oh, my God.
Well... probably not.
It's $3.
I don't think I would.
It's like $40 a year.
But I'm going to make her start paying for her car insurance.
Oh my God, that's worse.
That's only like $1,000.
Adulting is hard.
It is.
Cannot recommend. 0 stars.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
Brought to you by Mark's Payne Real Estate. It's almost Halloween. That means it's going to be candy corn season.
Yum.
I
almost
hate
Halloween.
Candy corn. Candy corn is an embarrassment to humanity.
You are very anti.
So dramatic.
It's like, oh, I got some candles. Let me dip them in sugar and eat them.
It just tastes like sugar.
Do you eat candles?
I mean, I would try it.
All right. Well, they have some new flavors you can try. They're doing tailgate flavored candy corn.
What do those taste like?
There's some that taste like hot dogs, hamburgers, popcorn, vanilla ice cream, and fruit punch.
I'm into the popcorn one.
Yes.
That I feel like would taste pretty good.
There's some there.
Because I don't know if you guys ever have done this, but if you put candy in your popcorn at the movie theater, like M&M's.
That's good.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Because it's like that sweet and salty.
I wouldn't want the hot dog flavor.
No, I think I'm good on that.
Okay. Yeah.
I love hot dogs, but I don't love them that
it's
much.
It's with wax and hot dog water.
Yummy.
Ricky, what you got?
So in a month, the prequel to Game of Thrones, House of Dragon, is going to be released on HBO. And in celebration of that, it just sounds so crazy to me. Duolingo is expanding your idea of High Valyrian, language that they use.
All right, yeah.
So they're giving courses so that you can learn how to actually speak that way.
A language they made up for this series.
That's why I'm just like so confused very.
Well, this is done before.
Yeah, but
there's
Star Trek
there's languages,
universe.
Yeah. Yeah, for like Star Trek, Klingon.
Yeah,
and
but like, wouldn't you want to learn a language that you can actually use?
No, this
in like everyday life.
Yeah, if you're a LARPer.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess. It just sounds really strange to me. But if you want to learn it, you can just sign up on Duolingo. You can learn how to speak High Valyrian and do it in time for the prequel to come out. And good luck to you on it.
And HBO Max will definitely their Apple crash on the opening night of that
as
show.
As it always does.
As it always does.
But then you could just call up your other friends and speak High Valyrian to them, and it's like you're watching it anyways.
Yeah, I'll give it to you play-by-play in Valyrian.
Jim?
There was no winner in the Mega Millions jackpot, so now the estimated pot of gold for the next one is $630 million, the fifth highest jackpot in Mega Millions history. Mm. But they say since, you know, when things hit these things, their predictions are usually low because people buy even more to get it.
Right,
so it could be worth a lot more than $630 million. But if it stays there and you choose to get the cash out instead of the 30 years, you know, a little bit every year, the cash out for $630 million is $360 million.
That is such a big difference.
I guess that would do.
Yeah, it's close to $500 million.
Now, Jim, being a powerful and influential member of the media, you got to see a sneak preview of the new Jordan Peele movie, Nope, last night.
Yep.
You saw Nope.
I saw Nope. And I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it.
I can't wait to see it.
It's like all the good stuff that Jordan Peele does with movies.
He's done really good stuff so far.
You know, Dread, but like he really makes a summer blockbuster out of this movie.
Very cool.
It does involve, you know, aliens and big things floating
from
outer space. And if you do love that, you'll really enjoy this movie. But I thought, okay, let's play a game of Nope. These are situations in which I'll tell you, you could get $1 million if you do this, but you've got to do that to get $1 million.
Okay.
And once presented with scenario, you've got to say, nope or yup. Those are the only two alternatives you have.
Okay.
You can explain late after you give your answer, but you have to say yup or nope.
Okay.
So definitely give us a call, 615-737-9107 if you want to get in on this. All right. Okay, I'm going to give you... This is a really simple one. I do have other ones that have aliens involved, though.
Okay.
But for you guys, would you drive from Seattle to Florida in a car that only goes 25 miles per hour maximum for $1 million?
Yep.
Yep.
That's two yups. Think about how long that would take.
Don't care. $1 million at the end?
It gives you several weeks to think about how you're going to spend that money.
Yep.
Several weeks? I think it's a lot longer than that. But I'd still probably do it.
So it's like driving through a school zone all the way to Florida?
Yes. Yes.
It would definitely make me a little crazy while I'm doing it.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
But I'd be excited at the end. Yeah. So it'd all be worth it.
If you think about it, Okay, say it took you 2 years. That's still
totally
half a million dollars a year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Totally fine with that.
All right. The other ones are not going to be that easy.
Okay.
That was a relatively
easy starter one.
A warm up.
It was not hard to say, yep. Okay. I've got some other ones where you might say, nope. An alien beams you into its ship and says, if you stick your hand into a box that you can't look into and hold it there for 10 minutes without taking your hand out or saying anything, it will give you $1 million. Do you put your hand in the box?
Yep.
I'd have to say yup, too. I'm all about aliens. I'm waiting for them.
Same. I think they know that we're friends, so I don't think they'd hurt me.
But why would they want to have your hand in that box?
Because it's an experiment.
But what if? Why did they?
I think that's the whole reason we're here is because we're an alien experiment. So they're just
quite
messing
possibly
with us.
Well, considering what people say they get abducted and have done to them, that's probably pretty easy.
This doesn't sound so bad.
Just remember, you can't say anything while your hand is in the box.
So it's going to be hard for me to not talk.
That's true.
But I think I could do it for $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
Even if something horrible is happening to your hand?
Yeah.
Well, you don't see what's happening to your hand, do you?
You just feel it.
Okay.
But you can't take it out.
Mm.
Second you take it out, you lose $1 million.
Listen, when you deal with a menstrual cycle every month, the pain that's inside that box is nothing compared to the pain that my uterus gives me.
That's just an alien cakewalk is all
exactly
that is.
Exactly.
Yeah. I know by Thursday
good
I'll be
point
fine. I can ride
good
this
point
out. All right, point taken.
All right, we got two yups.
Woody and Jim in the morning on 107.5 The River.
Ricky, what's making us happy?
This pizza delivery man who is a true hero. His name is Nicholas Bostic. He was driving along a street when he noticed that this house was just completely taken over by flames.
Like, oh, wow.
It was just up in flames. Wow. And there were no fire trucks or any emergency vehicles. Like, he couldn't hear anything coming. And he was like, okay, I need to do something. So he got out of his car and he ran into the fire, into the house.
Wow.
And started to just yell for anybody that may be trapped inside.
Right.
And as he was yelling, he like didn't hear anything, but he made his way through the house and he found 4 kids who were sleeping.
Oh, wow.
Yes. They aged from 1 year old to 18 years old. And they were all just in their bedrooms, didn't know what was happening.
Right.
He took them all out of the house when one said, there's still a 6-year-old kid inside.
Oh, geez.
He immediately turned around and went back into the house that is filled with flames and there's so much smoke everywhere.
Wow.
To find this girl. He said that he was met with just a massive cloud. Like, he couldn't see anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
He could see nothing in front of him. He didn't know where he was in the house.
It's not even his house. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So he's just yelling for this girl, trying to hear anything that he can hear.
Right.
And he finally heard her crying under the stairs or like down below where they originally were.
Oh.
And so he went through the smoke, covered his face with his t-shirt, went through the smoke, grabbed her, and the only way for him to get out was to hit through a window, break the glass, and kind of like jump out of the window.
Oh.
He jumped out of the window in a way that he could save her from any injury, and he fell obviously on himself.
Right.
By the time he was out, he saved all of the kids inside of the home, all 5 of them. But at a cost, he gravely cut his arm and he has severe smoke inhalation from being in there not once, but twice looking for people.
Oh, wow.
As of right now, he's doing okay.
Good.
On his GoFundMe page, the person who's running it said that he seems to be getting his humor back and he seems to be okay, very much like himself. He's overwhelmed with all the media that's happening around this.
I'm sure.
I mean, really, he's a true hero.
Yeah.
Seriously.
25 years old, by the way.
Yeah.
Most courageous thing I've heard in a long time.
Crazy.
I mean, because firefighters go in with all the protection on the equipment.
And he just went
in with just a t-shirt.
Yeah, just a t-shirt on. He just knew he had to do something. I guess he had a feeling that there was somebody still inside.
Oh, that's so cool.
And there was not just somebody. There were 5 kids. So.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm going to post on the River's story the link to his GoFundMe page.
I want that, yeah.
They have just surpassed their goal by so much. But if you feel inclined to donate, then obviously I want you to have an easy way to donate. So it'll
be
on 107.5 The River's Instagram stories.
That is really an awesome story. So it's making us happy this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River playing Yup, Nope.
All right, here's a scenario for you.
Okay.
Would you go nude 24 hours a day for a year, doing all the things you regularly do, and starting that year by spending the day at your massive family reunion for $1 million.
We've added a few layers.
Yup or nope? Nude all the time.
Side note, would I be able to explain why I'm naked?
That's a good question,
Woody. Yeah, I think you could.
Okay.
But you'd have to go and do the things you normally do now. Mm. So you couldn't hide in your house or anything like
that. Right, right. You'd still have to go to Kroger.
Do work and all that.
And I wouldn't get arrested.
Right.
For being nude all the time, correct?
You know?
Or is that a stipulation in this?
It's a little open. It's left to the listener to decide.
And it's for a full year?
For a year. Nude. Starting at your family reunion.
Okay, this is the first time I'm going to have to say nope.
We got a nope!
Oh, this is tough, though.
He says he wouldn't do it for the money.
Because I mean,
it'd
like,
have
if
to be more money.
Because like, I'm thinking, like, if you're nude, you're nude, whatever.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's not the end of the world. It's awkward to be around your family nude, though. That's very weird to me.
Would people invite you to things anymore?
Probably not. Probably not. Which might end up being a benefit, because then I would be inside all the time, and I wouldn't be outside nude.
True.
Speaking personally, I don't want to see myself naked, much less have to subject everyone else to it.
Frankly, when I was thinking about this question, Woody and I said, you have to do all the things you regularly do, like work. I'm like, all right, well, how much would it cost us to, like, well, outbid the $1 million to make you put clothes on?
That's right.
Can we get paid to have to endure?
That's what we start a bidding war.
That's a different question.
So
Rick, 24 hours a day nude for a year. You start with your family reunion for $1 million.
The family thing is what threw me off. I got to say nope.
It's two nopes.
If it had nothing to do with family, I'd say yep. But family, nope. That's just uncomfortable.
We've had a couple of comments on some of the previous questions talking about, you know, the first one was, would you drive from Seattle to Florida in a car that only goes 25 miles an hour?
Right. For $1 million.
Somebody did the math. Okay. It's 3,129 miles. So 25 miles an hour, it's 125 hours.
Oh, that's not too bad.
So that's 5 days.
That's nothing.
That's not bad. Okay.
Really?
Yeah.
That's just, yeah, it doesn't seem bad at all.
No.
I think it's, although it says 5 days, it's like, what are those 5 days like, though? I mean, we all hate driving.
They're excruciating.
In that slow speed, you know, mode.
Mm-hmm.
I think you might go insane. You might not make it.
A little bit.
All right.
No, but if you're rich and insane, you're called eccentric.
That's true.
You're not insane. Yeah, right. All right. We have one more scenario for yep or nope.
All right. All right. Oh, which one should I use? All right. Maybe one or two here.
Okay.
I'm gonna throw at you. Okay. All right. This is a classic. Would you sacrifice another person's life on the other side of the world for $1 million?
Nope.
Nope.
Two nopes on that one.
No. That's a no-brainer.
Okay. Yeah, that is kind of how about this one?
Unless he was a jerk.
You don't know.
If it's Alex.
You don't know.
It's Vladimir Putin. I'd say yep.
Right? Yeah, it depends on the person.
Yeah.
Would you eat nothing but cat food for a year for $1 million?
Nope.
That's another nope. Yes. Woody's thinking about it. Cat food.
My cat really enjoys it, but...
But will you?
Think about like day 34.
I'd have to say nope on that
one
too.
I love food way too much.
Yes! All right. Hey, if anybody out there, if you want to answer this one just to entertain us here in the studio, text us your answer, nope or yup, to this 64895. Put WJ in the message and then just say nope or yup and you can follow it up. I'll give him an alien one, okay? An alien levitates you out of your bed.
Mm-hmm.
They have large fangs, but otherwise seem unthreatening. Using telepathy, they tell you to get on their ship with them. They'll bring you back in a year and give you $1 million for your troubles.
Hmm.
Do you take the ride for $1 million?
Okay, we'll give you some time to think about it, but text in your answer.
64895, put WJ in the message, and then nope or yup take the ride for a year, where they say, yeah, at the end of the year, we'll give you $1 million.
Would you fly into space with a giant fanged alien?
Now, mind you, nothing's guaranteed. You're taking their word for it.
Yeah.
So how much do you trust the alien with the big fang?
Stick around, coming in about 15 minutes. You can be drinking beer outside with other beer enthusiasts. It's the Music City Brewers Fest.
It turns 21 years old this year.
It's old enough to drink at its own event now.
Exactly.
Any chance to win those coming up in about 15 minutes at 7:40. Right now, the Clash of the Titans. It's Gender Wars.
It's time for men and women to answer questions for Gender Wars.
Ready to go with our game for the ladies in the audience. We have Emily in Unionville. Hey there, Emily.
Hello.
Welcome.
For the guys, we have Josh in Bowling Green. Hello, Josh.
Hello, good morning.
All right, good luck to both of you. We have a Get Acquainted question to warm up with.
Yeah, let's start with you, Josh. Tell us something that you'll never do again.
Ride the Tilt-A-Whirl.
Oh, no.
I want to know, what did you hurl at the Tilt-A-Whirl?
Maybe.
That's all he's willing to admit to. Okay.
And I can never wear that shirt again.
Emily, tell us one thing you'll never do again.
Ride the Fearfall.
Ride the Fearfall?
Mm-hmm.
Is that a roller coaster?
It's a ride that goes way up in the air and just drops
they
you
drop
down.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That
yeah.
one.
All right.
I loved that when I did it, but I'm also insane, so it makes sense.
Right.
Well, there you go.
Well, your stomach kind of goes in your throat as you plummet toward Earth.
Sure.
Yes.
Everything about it feels wrong.
Yeah,
that's
I love
it's
it.
So right. All right, you each have a screw you can use. If you don't know the answer to a question and you don't think your opponent knows it either, you can yell screw before the buzzer, and we'll give your question to your opponent.
Here we go. Emily, multiple choice. Was last night's baseball All-Star game played in Chicago, Las Vegas, or Los Angeles?
Los Angeles.
Yes.
Just made it.
You made it just in time. You got it.
Correct. It's 1-0.
All right, Josh. Sarah Hyland hosts the new season of Love Island. Is that streaming on Netflix, Hulu, or Peacock?
Hulu.
No. It's on Peacock.
It's on Peacock.
Yeah. I wouldn't know that it's on Peacock either, because what the heck is even
Nobody
on there?
Nobody knows it's on Peacock.
It's still a mystery. Emily, take a big lead here. In car terms, what's the main difference between a coupe and a sedan?
The doors?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
number
exactly
of doors.
Right.
Just coupes has two, and a sedan has four doors.
It's 2-0. Josh, she is in the lead, and she puts you in the terrible position of having to get this one right to stay alive.
You're mixing up daiquiris. What type of alcohol will you need?
Vodka?
It's rum.
It's rum. That means, Emily, you are the winner. Congratulations.
Emily, we're going to hook you up with a couple of tickets to go see the man with the voice, the crooner himself, Michael Bublé. Two tickets at Bridgestone on August 16th. And also one of the funniest guys.
He is a really nice guy. And when we talk to him, he pretends to like us. So I like that.
Nice.
Before the break, we gave you a scenario that you had to say yep or nope to.
Yeah, so an alien levitates you out of your bed.
Mm-hmm.
It has large fangs, but seems otherwise not threatening. Using telepathy, the alien says to you, come leave on our ship with me, and I'll bring you back in a year, and I'll give you $1 million for your troubles at the end of the year. Do you get on that ship?
Is it a yep or a nope?
So what are they saying?
Our listeners mostly say nope.
Have some fun.
I wouldn't trust my sweet old lady neighbor to not kill me with an offer like that, let alone a fanged alien.
Okay. I see where they're going with that one.
Now, Ricky, you like have said, without even anybody asking, for as long as we've known you, that you get on a ship and leave this planet in a heartbeat.
100%.
A lot of that. We had several texts saying, like, yeah, just get me off Earth. I don't care.
Yeah, this place is trash right now. Like, I'm ready to go.
It's got
to
be better.
Sounds like a nice year-long vacation, if you ask me.
Yeah.
Do the fangs give you any
hesitation? No, fangs don't bother me.
All right. Bring on the fangs.
I hope they give me fangs, too, so we can all, like, look alike, you know?
Okay.
I can assimilate into the alien culture with
my fangs.
That way
you'll blend in, yeah.
$1 million and the right plastic surgeon in Brentwood, you could get your own fangs when you get back.
I'd have to say yep, too, because, yeah, aliens take me away.
Everyone's really upset with Kylie Jenner right now because she had posted a picture of her and Travis Scott on a runway with two jets behind them with the caption that says, "You want to take mine or yours?" She thought this was like a huge flex to kind of show off how much money they have. But then the internet came for her because she apparently uses this jet for very short trips.
Uh-huh.
Like trips that would be 40 minutes in the car. She's taking her jet to go to these places.
Oh, okay.
Which is terrible for the environment.
Sure.
Like horrible for the environment. One of the flight trackers noticed that she took her plane for a 3-minute flight. 3 minutes.
So, like, to get to the other side of the store, she, instead of just, you know, walking the aisles, booked, you know, her own private jet.
Yep, pretty much.
Jeez.
Which is just absolutely insane. Just to give you an idea of why people are so upset about this, a private jet's engines can dump up to 2 tons of carbon dioxide in an hour.
That's huge.
Which is more than some people will create in an entire year.
That's more hot air than all the Kardashians put together.
Yeah, and that's more than some airliners carrying 200 or 300 people.
Yeah.
These
days. Like, because it's that. Yeah, private jets are just really
terrible for the environment.
Cost efficient. Yeah.
It's good that she can relate to us, the common people.
Ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
I need to go check the mail, but I don't feel like I'm walking all the way down to the street.
Take a freaking jet.
I'll take my plane. Yeah.
Out of control.
We love it when our cars do cool things, but soon we're gonna have to pay a little extra.
This chaps my you know what.
Yeah, this is not fair.
Okay, like and sometimes I'm like this, like, hey, if you can afford a super expensive car, who cares if they're but I have a feeling these things filter down. BMW has started subscription service for using the heated seats.
Insane.
If you have heated seats in your car.
So you're already paying more for the heated seats and then even more on top of what you already paid.
You have to subscribe to have the luxury. To have the heated seats.
That's insane.
Now, you think right now,
hell no.
It's actually the perfect time to let people know that because, like, who the heck wants heated seats in, you know, this magnifying glass, you know, held over the earth.
Pretty much your heated seats are just coming from the sun now.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But when you do want them, you have to pay an extra $18 a month.
18?
Yeah.
What?
It's not $5. It's not $3 or $10. $18 a month to use the feature that you paid for at the beginning.
When you bought the car originally, yeah.
And they said there's other, like, luxury features that are going to start going on a subscription service where they say, oh, well, you know, you didn't pay for them up front because, you know, we say that we didn't charge you, but they charged you for it.
Of course they did.
This is going to be like some of the cheaper airlines where they charge you for everything, you know, like,
oh, yeah.
Would you like a seat?
Bring your own seat, and also we're going to charge you to breathe.
Right. So,
would you like a passenger seat in your car?
Okay. Oh, you didn't bring a seat? We'll give you a folding chair, and we'll buckle it to the floor for another $40.
Wow. Now, would you have to pay for this, like, annually, or would you still have to pay for it now?
I would imagine you could, like, you know, not pay for it during the summer.
6 months out of the year or something. Yeah,
you could, like, kick it in, you know.
But that just is ridiculous.
It is, you know. Like, once, I know the bank owns it until you really own it, but once you've bought the car, it's over.
Yeah.
You don't get to keep taking money
from me. Right, right.
That's, it ends.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, we don't have a relationship. We had a one afternoon stand at the manager's office inside the car dealership.
Right.
Yeah, no, it's insane. It's also insane to think that when your car is paid off, that you're still paying
a
subscription fee
yeah,
to use the things that you bought it for.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
I have an older car. It's a 2014 Maxima that's paid off, and yet it has the heated seats and the steering wheel and everything. I would not pay extra for that.
Yeah.
See, this is the rough part is like I have heated seats in my car as well, and I love them so much that I would really have to debate with myself if I'm going to pay this or not. I feel like part of me would have to prove a point and not pay for it, but then I would be so sad getting into my car and not using it.
Driver, you just work with a frigid butt.
Yeah. I love my heated seats.
Morning and Jim in the morning, 107.5 The River. You may have noticed that the world around us is a horrifying dumpster fire, so we don't like talking about that. We like to make our own fun.
Let's do party games instead.
So we're going to play the mixtape game where you get a scenario and then you have to come up with a song that we'd be playing that would fit the scenario.
Exactly. So the first one's kind of simple. We'll ease into it. The scenario is you stub your toe, and for the 30 seconds of blinding pain right after, what song is ringing through your ears? So, Woody, you've just slammed your toe into something, and oh, it hurts. What song is blaring through your brain?
I picked Prince, When Doves Cry, but only the beginning part, where he says... Actually make that sound for a lot of things.
Right.
As my girlfriend, I do that all the time.
Woody, we have a Teams meeting with that boss from out of town.
Very fitting.
I thought so.
All right. Ricky, what happens with the blinding pain from the toe you just jammed into some concrete door or something?
I did Everybody Hurts.
All right.
Well, everybody hurts. But sometimes
it's like when you start to see like the light and this is all you hear because it hurts so bad.
Go to the light.
That you know death is imminent.
The crying in your car before you go into work song.
I totally get you. My stub toe mixtape song is sort of similar to Woody's in that I've chosen just a part of a song that represents my blinding pain, and that's Mark Ronson and Bruno Mars, Uptown Funk. This is what I hear after I stub my toe. It's just me crying out.
Right before he says, here's my glass, put some liquor in it.
Yeah, that's what I said. Put a lot of liquor in it.
Exactly.
This hurts. It's for medicinal purposes only. Yes. All right, so that was like a really simple version of the game.
Yeah.
All right, let's get ready for our next mixtape scenario.
Okay.
And anybody can chime in and let us know what song would be playing if they went through this.
This is the second one has got a little bit more meat to it. It's a little meatier.
All right. You run into your ex, the one that broke your heart for the very first time. But they ask you to get coffee and maybe catch up.
Aw.
But you are so over them. What song is playing as you say no to catching up?
So many options.
If you can say no musically.
Yes. The options are wide. If we love your idea, we'll put yours on the air, too. So let us know. You can also tweet us at Woody and Jim Show or hit us up on at Woody and Jim Show on Instagram.
Ricky?
Sure. I did Independent Women by Destiny's Child. Don't need no man.
Hold your head up high. Walk away. Strut away.
Yeah, strut away is actually more like it. If you're listening to this song, you're strutting.
Yes.
Yeah. It's totally, it's like, I'm in a better place than you are.
Yep.
Do we have anybody on the phone?
Yes, we do. We have Tamay on the line. Hey, what would be the song that's playing in your head when your ex says, let's get together for coffee, and you want to say no?
Big Black Horse and the Cherry Tree. And I say no, 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 no.
I love that you did your own little clip for us so that everybody knows what you're talking about.
I know. You did your own production for the show. That was good.
Well done.
Thank you.
Inspired, I might say.
Yeah. It's a yes for me. You're going to Hollywood.
Oh, well, thank you. I won't forget about y'all when I make it. When I get my star on the Walk of Fame, You guys are all invited.
All right.
You're the sweetest.
We'll get to carry the the concrete that they pour.
I'll go ahead and put that in my Google calendar. That's awesome.
Tomei, you're thank awesome. You, thank you.
You have a good one.
Have a wonderful day.
You too. That's so sweet.
All right, I've got one. And in fact, we just played this artist a few minutes ago. As my ex, who I'm done with, wants to catch up again. I think the modern day, like, it's got to be Lizzo.
Could I had a bad bitch?
Sorry. You missed out.
This totally makes sense, yep.
Could have had this. Don't you holding me back. And
that's the bad. Stick around, come out after the break. I've got a song for you. And also, Corey, one of our listeners, wants to chime in on what he would play.
Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on the River.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. Here's an amazing accomplishment, I guess. There's a guy named Bob Salem who's making news in Colorado. He is only the fourth person in history to push a peanut up Pike's Peak.
Oh, yes, I saw this.
With his nose.
Okay, Pike's Peak is like miles long and super steep, and it's a windy road, right?
He did it in only 7 days. Breaking the previous record by a full day.
Wow.
He's the fourth person to do it in history. But why?
The mental strength to do that, though, like, you mentally have to be ready for that. Because I'd lose my mind.
He made a contraption that's pretty much just duct tape and a big spoon from the kitchen. And he's pushing it up. If you want to see what it looks like on his journey, he posted it on the Woody and Jim Show Instagram story.
Well, with the heat wave, like he'd be down against, like right against the asphalt, that would be like brutal.
Yeah.
I guess Manitou Springs, which is at the foot of Pike's Peak, is celebrating their 150th anniversary. So he says, I'll find a way to celebrate. Where's my peanut?
Congrats to him.
Man. No, well done, sir.
It's going to look great on a resume.
Ricky, what you got?
So happy National Hot Dog Day.
Yay!
And one of my favorite things is finding out people break ridiculous records for ridiculous things. And this one's hot dog related for National Hot Dog Day.
Okay.
Two guys broke the record for hot dog throwing.
Hot dog throwing?
Yes. It's where they throw the hot dog and the other person has to catch it. In the bun.
In a bun. Oh.
Oh, okay.
So the one guy threw the hot dog 167 feet and 5 inches into his partner's hand that had a bun.
Wow.
Into his bun hand. And they broke the record by more than 10 feet.
That video is not going to be used as a metaphor for anything.
No, no.
I just love the most random Guinness World Records that I can find. Like, this is ridiculous.
That's pretty cool.
Who even knew that this is possible?
Right?
Not I.
No.
Jim?
So there's this thing that they say can help cool off your car almost instantly without making, like, the car's air conditioning, like, work too hard, you know, therefore, like, burning more gas, which is really expensive, one of the many problems we have. So they say, if you have access at home or wherever you are during the day, to come out to your car with a wet rag and hold it over the air conditioning vent that where the air conditioning would come out, it will cool your car down really quickly. But you got to have a wet rag. And hold it over the vent for like 5 minutes.
I don't know if I believe this.
I don't know.
Also, where are you going to get a wet rag from? If I'm in Target for 4 hours, because, you know, Target tells you what to buy and you walk around and then you realize, oh my God, it's been 4 hours. Yep. I'm not going to have a wet rag.
Tell you what, Target is going to have wet rags for sale right near where you're leaving.
Yeah. As you're leaving?
And then you just go right into the bathroom, right under the sink.
Target, be smart.
Target knows.
Put it right there for your impulse buy. Yeah.
You don't know what
smart
you want.
To do it.
Target knows what you want.
Playing the mixtape game, the scenario is your ex. You run into your ex that broke your heart, and then they say, hey, let's get together and have some coffee and kind of catch up. And you don't want to because you're so over them. What song is playing as you say no? I found one. I mean, after 20 minutes of going,
thinking about all your exes.
Not all of them.
The majority. It's okay.
Makes it sound like. But anyway, I would go 100% JoJo.
Ah, yes.
Nice.
A classic.
I like it. JoJo's a good choice.
It is a good choice.
I don't care what you're picking it for.
If you're looking for vengeance,
JoJo. That's an excellent one.
Corey is on the line. So you have a song that would fit the scenario?
Yeah, I think I would play Ludacris's Move.
I like it. Get that anger out early in the morning. That's right.
Great choices by everyone.
Yeah, I know.
Good job, everybody.
I actually would love to replace the horn on my car with Corey's selection. Yeah, if somebody's like in front of me on I-24 and they haven't realized that, you know, traffic has picked up and started moving again, you just honk that horn and
I would fully laugh at anyone who had this as their horn, though. I would not take you serious.
Technology is catching up. We will have this one day.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Gonna move out of the way for the guy with this as a horn. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Woody and Jim in the Morning, 107.5 The River. We're all familiar with the sound of white noise, you know, kind of when the TV gets jammed between channels and it makes that sound.
A lot of us have white noise machines.
To help you sleep or help you concentrate.
Yep.
Right now, all over TikTok, people are talking about brown noise.
It's better.
It's like the same thing, only slightly lower. It doesn't sound so much
deeper,
like that.
Deeper, smoother tones.
A lot of people say it helps them clear their mind. That their mind is
kind of sounds like the beach.
It does. It sounds like waves.
That's exactly what I was gonna say. Yeah, it sounds like you mixed in some waves, which is like that same frequency. Yeah. Like we use waves in our room, like when we're sleeping.
Yeah,
it's calming.
Yeah, but if not, I pull this up. Like there's 10 hours of this on YouTube.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's what I'm playing right now.
If I'm in like a if I'm in a hotel room or something, and I'll have that little machine. This is what I play.
Yeah,
I like it.
A lot of people are, you know, all over TikTok talking about it, how it's really helping them concentrate, clear their mind, because our brains are so busy right now.
Mm-hmm.
And they say, and I'm not sure, there's like, I'm sort of an audiophile, but not as much as most people in this town, because it's a music town, right? But white noise is supposedly like kind of all the frequencies at once coming at you.
It's a little harsher.
Yeah. And the brown noise, like, has a like an energy decreasing quality to it that like kind of puts you at ease.
It calms you. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, let's just listen for this the next 8 hours.
I'm not opposed, if I'm being honest, because I already feel relaxed. So
I'm also already at work. Like, there's no chance I'm just gonna like nod off.
Yeah.
So maybe I'll fall asleep.
Maybe
right forever. Here.
I mean, like. Well, I'm driving. That's the problem.
So
like,
that's true.
I'm thinking like maybe our traffic reports are going to get a lot worse the more we play it.
Right. So we'll just go ahead and stop then.
Thanks for listening to and recommending the Woody and Jim Show podcast. Listen to Woody and Jim in real time every weekday morning on 107.5 The River, Nashville, or live on the iHeartRadio app.